Hi everybody, welcome you all to online course in spoken English, and we have been discussing modals for the last two sessions, and we shall continue with the same topic today. Today we shall continue with the next modal, that is may, and the first and the foremost function of this modal is seeking permission, and it is used in our day-to-day life in different circumstances, right? See, may I go out, seeking permission to go out. You may go now. So it is giving permission. First one is seeking permission, and the second one is giving permission. May we wind up the class now? So seeking permission to end the class. And then possibility. So may, it's also used to show the possibility. He may call you now. It's possible that he may call you now. And you may be required to talk now. Doctors may find it difficult to treat him. It might be difficult for doctors to treat him. So these are the possibility. It is possible that he may call you now. You may be required to talk now. It is possible that you should go and talk now. You should represent all of us now. And doctors may find it, the disease is very severe and it is uncontrollable. Doctors may find it difficult to treat him. So it is possibility. So mainly may is used to say, one is to express permission and the other one is to express possibility. And as I discussed earlier, we can also, give our blessings using may. May God bless you. May you have good luck. May you live long. So these are also used. But in most of the day-to-day conversation and context, may is used mainly for permission and possibility. And then we can move on to the next modal auxiliary, that is might. So might also works just as may, but it is more polite when seeking permission. See, polite permission. Might I get back soon? It's a permission. Okay. Might I get back soon? The person is sounding very polite. Might I get back soon? Might I say something about the issue? So he is taking everybody's permission. He is very humble. And then he is seeking everybody's permission to speak out, to say something about the issue. Might we be seated? So he's not asking, may I sit here? He's saying, might I be seated or might we be seated? He is seeking the permission of the person to give him, to permit him to be seated there. And then possibility. So when it comes to possibility, probability is very less. It is less possible when compared with the possibility with may. Okay, it may rain tonight. Possibility, it might rain tonight. Possibility is less. Okay, less in degree. Then the parcel might reach us tomorrow. It is of course not possible. It may be. So there is a little possibility. The parcel might reach us tomorrow. The professor might return tonight. We are not sure. He might return tonight. Rajesh might be late if he doesn't start soon. He might be late. The person is not very sure, damn sure, that he will be late. He is saying he might be late if he doesn't start now. He's already late and it is high time he should start now. And then coming for the next modal auxiliary, that is must. Okay, must is mainly used for obligation, right? I must start soon. So he is putting an obligation for himself. It is a condition. So I must start soon or else I'll be left behind. I must start my work soon. Radha must complete the project by this weekend. Otherwise she'll be fired by her boss. She should be fired by her boss. Her boss would not spare her. So Radha, it is compulsory for Radha, or it is mandatory for Radha to complete her project by this weekend. Abdul must see his mother soon. She is ailing. She is on a deathbed. He must see his mother soon. She has expressed a desire to see her son. So it is an obligation, right? Then must is also used for certainty. He must be waiting for us. It is certain that the person must be waiting for us. We told him to wait there for us at the railway station and he must be waiting. It is certain that the person must be waiting. He has been working continuously since morning. He must be tired. It is certain that since he has been working since morning without taking rest, he must be tired. The person is making a guess and he is certain that he must be tired. He must have told you the truth. It is certain that he must have told, even if he has not told the truth to anybody, he must have told you. Because you are a special person in his life. And he must not tell a lie to you. He must have told you the truth. So it is certain. And then we shall, must. The negative of must is mustn't. And mustn't can be used for prohibition. Right? You mustn't walk on the lawn. And it will be written. And if there is a lawn, And there will be a board, bill board. There will be a board. It will be giving you, you know, prohibition. It says you mustn't walk on the lawn. It is prohibited. Walking on the lawn is prohibited. He mustn't smoke here. Okay, no smoking zone. The people here should not smoke. So he must not smoke here. It is prohibited that smoking is prohibited. Smoking is prohibited in this area, and he should not smoke here. And then you mustn't talk over phone now. So it's a meeting. Everybody is seriously discussing an issue, and you mustn't talk over phone now. Talking over phone at this moment is prohibited. You cannot talk over phone at this time. It is prohibited. Okay, we shall move on to the next model, that is will. We can make predictions. Predictions means making guesses for future. It will happen. If this is so, it will happen. Okay, it's very cloudy. It will rain tonight. It's very cloudy. See, it is overcast. The sky is overcast and it will rain tonight. Don't go out in the rain. You will catch cold. If you go out in the rain, you will catch cold. Don't go out in the rain. You will catch cold. So the person is making a prediction. If you go out in the rain without wearing sweater and without holding an umbrella, you will catch cold, right? Then making a promise. I will finish all the homework by Friday. The person is making a promise. I am promising that I will be able to complete all the homework by Friday. And then he'll help you complete the project. He is giving a promise. That that person whom I introduced you to, he is a very nice person and he'll help you complete the project. They'll take care of your father. Don't worry. They'll take care of your brother. I can assure you. I can promise you that they will take care of your father. Then will is also used for request and demand. And sometimes it uses the word please, okay, to sound more polite and to make it a very emphatic request. Will you please give me that book? Will you please give me that book? The person is making a request. Will you carry the bag for me? It sounds a bit, you know, demanding, right? When we use the word please, it sounded request. When we use the word will you carry the bag for me without the word please, it is a demand. So will can be used either to make demand or to make a request. So will is used for making prediction, promise and request or demand. Then we shall move on to the next one, that is would. Would is used as the past form of will. Prashant said that he would give me his book. Prashant will give his book is in the present tense. Would, he said that he would give. So he promised that he would give his book to me. Yusuf promised me that he would reach the place well in advance. He promised me, he gave me a word that he would reach the place well in advance. So it was in the past. He made a promise in the past. And then I knew they would not help you. I knew very well that they, even though they said that they would help you, I knew very well that they would not help you. These are all the past form of will. They are used for saying certainly about somebody or making promises, or talking about promises that were made in the past. And then would is also used for making polite request and demand. Okay, polite request or demand. Would you mind opening the window, please? Would you mind opening the window, please? Do you have any objection for the window being opened? Okay, do you have any objection? Would you mind means I want to open the window. Do you have any problem? Okay, or would you mind opening the window? Here the person is suggesting, instead of, you know, he himself opening the window, he is requesting the other person to please open the window. Don't you have any problem opening the window for me? So he is making a very polite request to the person to open the window. And would you wait till he comes back? Would you wait till he comes back? So yes, you have already waited for long. Would you wait till he comes back? He may not come back soon. Would you wait? So making a polite request. It indirectly suggests that you please wait till he comes. So these are the usages of would. Next one is shall. Okay, shall is used commonly in our day-to-day conversation. One is for prediction, that this time, tomorrow, I shall be writing my final exam. Means tomorrow, at this time, at the time of speaking. Not tomorrow, I am speaking at 12:30 p.m. and tomorrow at 12:30 p.m. I will be writing my examination. I shall have finished my work by this time next month. By this time next month, by 10th of next month, I shall have finished my work. So it makes predictions about future. And then shall is also used for making offers and suggestions, right? Shall we go for a walk now? offer or suggestion. Shall we go for a walk now? Making a suggestion. Shall we go for a walk now? And shall we start the class now? The teacher making a suggestion to the student. Shall we start the class now? So she might have discussed other things prior to the beginning of the class, and she making a request finally. Shall we start the class now? Shall we eat out tonight? So putting a proposal. Okay, making a proposal. Shall we eat out tonight? We have been eating, you know, at home, and we are bored of the dishes here. We shall taste something different tonight. So shall we eat out tonight? The person is making an offer or a suggestion, right? This is about shall. The next modal auxiliary, that is should. Okay, should is used mainly used for advice, and should is not as strong as must. Must is always used for obligation, and should is used to make an advice. Okay, give a piece of advice. You should consult the doctor. Okay, you seem to be very ill, and after taking medicine, even after, you know, making self-medication, you are not okay. You should consult the doctor. I am advising you to consult the doctor. It is my concern, it is my advice that you go and consult a doctor immediately. He should stop smoking now, or else he would develop serious health problems. Okay, he has already, the doctor has diagnosed with asthma, and still he keeps smoking. He should stop smoking now. It is my advice that he should stop smoking, or else he would develop serious health issues. Okay, his health may deteriorate again, and he may develop some other problems. So he should stop. It is my advice that he should stop smoking now. Then she should listen to her parents before she takes any decision. Before she takes any decision, she should listen to her parents. She is not listening to her parents. It is better that she should listen to her parents. And it is my advice to her to listen to her parents. And then I have already told you, it is also used for obligation and order, but it is not as strong as must. You should attend all the classes. You should not miss any class. You should attend all the classes. It is compulsory. It is binding on you to attend all the classes. Then he should not speak rudely to his parents. So it is not advisable. He should not do it. And he should always respect his parents. He should not speak rudely to his parents. She should be instructed to behave sensibly. She is very rude with other people, and she should be instructed to behave sensibly. And then it is also used for expectations. You should complete the assignment before the end of the next month. There might be compulsion, a little bit of compulsion, but the person is saying you are expected to complete the assignment before the end of the next month. You are expected to complete the assignment before the end of the next month. Okay, before the month ends, you should be ready with the assignment. And he should read the novel and write a review as soon as possible. It's already late, and I expect him to read the novel, and he should write a review after reading the novel, right? And polite suggestion. Okay, polite suggestion means, you know, in the form of a question, we can make a suggestion. Indirectly, we can suggest to people, should I say anything more? Should I say anything more, or is it enough? And should he tell you the truth now? Should he tell you the truth now? He is making a polite suggestion. Okay, then we shall move on to the last one in this category, that is ought to. Okay, must, should, and ought to. Of course, they are one and the same, but there is a little bit of difference in the degree. Okay, then ought to is mainly used for obligation, and it is usually used for moral obligation. People opine that it is mainly used for moral obligations. You ought to love your country. It's a moral obligation. You ought to respect your parents. It's a moral obligation. Okay, moral obligation. And then obligation instituted by the constitution and state and other things, right? You ought to give your resignation now. You should give. It is an obligation. It is high time that you should tender your resignation. She ought to come back soon. She ought to come back soon, or else she might face the consequences. It is an obligation. We ought to respect our national anthem. This falls under our patriotism and other things. Okay, constitution, state, policies and other things. We ought to respect our national anthem. It is binding on us to respect our national anthem. And ought to is also used to give advice to people. You ought to eat good food, otherwise you may become weak. It's an advice. It functions exactly the same way as should. right? Giving an advice. You ought to eat good food, otherwise you may become weak. If you do not eat good food, you will become weak. It is my advice for you to eat good food so that you can stay fit, you can stay healthy. She ought to be cautious about her friends who are really cunning. She has to be very careful about her friends. This is my advice for her to be careful about her friends because they are very cunning. So this is giving an advice. These are the different types of models and functions. Thank you all. Have a nice time. Bye-bye.